What is going on, everybody? Welcome back today, guys, to the channel. Top 5 drifts of the week is back on this Friday, man. Week number 6 for today, man. Consecutive weeks here. Give me a round of applause. I do appreciate that. Today's starting us off with a huge 360 initiation here into Rio with the limo. That is not an easy thing to do. Really wanted this for the top 5 today, but just did not make the cut. However, though, love the clip. If you guys were around last week, we did a vote for number 1, and the 7-man train ended up winning that. So congratulations to everybody in there and the TUS guys for placing in that tie for number 1. This week, wasn't the easiest week to, put down these clips. I did want to do a 10, didn't really feel that I had a quality of, 10 really good clips, so I brought it down to 5 for today. Hopefully you guys do enjoy it. If you do, go ahead, slap that like button. I really do appreciate that. Mambo333, he had a really nice reverse initiation on here. Unfortunately, the camera work with the guy back there, just, it wasn't exactly what I wanted for a top 10. We also had Complex throwing down a beautiful run here on Road Atlanta. I just really wanted to see him a little bit more aggressive on that starting initiation, but he does hit all of his clipping points. If this was for ESTA, he'd be scoring very, very high. Now, if you guys don't know how to enter in 2 top 10 drifts or top 5 drifts, it's very simple. In the description box down below, there will be a link and template for you guys to fill out. Attach your YouTube video, public or unlisted, so that way I can see it. YouTube may be in top 5 or 10 drifts of the week. Now, last episode, though, there was something that I needed to correct. Unfortunately, I did make an error, and I gave number 4 to the wrong person. I said it was Pocket Slevin, when actually it was Boosted 427. He actually let me know on Twitter, so huge thank you for responding on Twitter and letting me know about that error. Long story short, I was using a different program to download the clips. I had to then match the names up with the clips, and just, things got kind of shaken up. Gave the credit to the wrong person, so I do apologize for that. But that was Boosted's clip on there. If you guys missed that, make sure you guys go check out last week's episode. Trying to keep them consistent for you guys, man. It's been one of the biggest things that I wanted to keep track on this series. And I love this series, right? I love going through your guys' clips and, seeing the creative things that you guys have done, or just, the impressive things, like this one here from Ruby Drill. Unfortunately, just did not make the top 5 cut, but huge reverse entry, holds on to it very nicely, and just clean. There was no, hesitation in that throw. I did like that. We're down to the top 5 of the week, man. We're starting down the countdown today. Number 5, Forza Horizon 3. We got Gicky coming up here with a Lexus SC300, and he's going to dip a few tires. I chose this clip just on sheer throttle and car control. If you guys watch this, this is a very controlled run, and he does his best to get right to the edge on all of these corners, and he does exactly that. It's 2 tires now that he has dropped. And just, pay attention to his lines. They're very smooth, they're very precise right there. He dropped the tire, had to correct himself, and that's going to be the end of his freestyle. But really did enjoy that one. Just, overall car control. Number 4, returning members from World Drift, Star, Sax, and Exes. These guys are killing it. Hopefully, I did pronounce that right as well. I'm terrible on that, man. I did like this clip, though, because of the fact the S corner, you can see the entire thing in one camera motion. It was a really creative shot. I did like that a lot. The guys were killing it, though, man. All 3 of the same cars. Number 3, Waffle Boss. He's on a little bit of Assetto Corsa Toge. He's driving the S13 Drift Workshop 2018 Street Pack. And this is the Toge 1990s version as well, too. So this is a really nice, just consistent, controlled run of 2 guys throwing down some really nice tandems out here. And this is the definition of why I love this game. It's because of the mountain roads, just the range of freedom and car selection that you do have. And, to be able to do things like this on a nightly basis, whenever you want, it definitely does take the cake for, the best drifting simulator that I've played, in my personal opinion, of just, an overall total package. But that driving, though, that was a total package, man. Definitely like that. Number 2, TXR Natty and Noise Bomb B1. Now, I don't know how they did the replays the way that they did them, looking around. I don't know if this is the replay and then looking around, or if this is actually a VR situation, which I don't believe that the PSVR can go online. So if you guys can, describe this, how is he looking side to side? We definitely appreciate it. I love that, brought that cinematic feel to this clip, and just overall sheer tandems, man. Look at him just reeling them in on this outside line. Very nice driving by both drivers. Love the aggressiveness of this as well, too. And just clean runs, man. They didn't make contact once. Number one, though, Datafy. Live for speed. We've seen Datafy before. This man is good, and he's going to prove that one more time. We got a high-speed solo drift here. We got the wheel and pedal cam going down. He's driving the XRT on Kyoto GP reversed. And the man's got some skill, though. This is not an easy game by any means. I have played Live for Speed before. I did love it. I'm actually thinking about getting back into it. If that's something you guys want to see, let me know down below. But I do believe his rig, it's not listed, but that does look like the TSPC racer there. We have the T3PA pedals underneath there, and then maybe a wheel stand pro holding that together. He's got a flight stick, I believe, for the handbrake. But just maximum car control. You can see him with his throttle response, his braking, just everything is on point. I'm gonna let you guys have a listen to this. Turn up your speakers for a little bit, because he's not done yet, man. This guy's gonna keep on going for a few. Out there. I mean, I don't know. Who would you think is the best on a wheel, man? Leave me your thoughts down below. Would love to see some more wheel entries coming in, because I love watching these. I really do. You get to see everything, especially with that pedal cam as well, too. Great lighting everywhere. You can really see his movements pretty clear. And I did like the fact that he made it into a third-person camera on the replay angle, but actually, though, he's in cockpit view. You guys can see that on the far right on your screen right there. So I did like that transition. You know, there was work into this. You know, we did make it watchable as well, too. And I did like that third-person perspective on the clip. And that's why I felt he deserved number one for today's top five drifts, man. Let me know your thoughts down below. Did you agree with the lineup for today? If not, and think that you can do better, well, by all means, man, send in your clips for next week. We have a couple montages that I did want to show you guys as well, too. But just, the man keeps going, though. I had to cut him off because he was just taking too much stage time up there. I was like, nope, you know what? Plug is pulled. But huge thank you, though, Datafy, for sending that in. Really nice to see that. Just, it was almost hypnotizing, man. I did like that. Montages, though, coming up. Grassroot Digital, we've seen them many times. These guys are throwing down a banger, some IRL clips, in-car tandems. We got some outside views as well, too. Really nice montage. These guys always come through. Let's have a quick listen. Living dead. Got a dead bitch living here. Two new flowers growing on my bed. Brush some blood settle on my leg. Hurt so hard. Full link will be found down below in the description box for that montage. Second up, though, One Way Gaming with a Grand Theft Auto 5 5M tandem train montage. I did like this one a lot as well, too. Really nice cinematic angles. These guys are good, man. I'd love to know your thoughts. If you guys have any montages that you have made, send them in. They could be featured at the end of top 10 or 5 drifts of the week, right? I'm still on that balance of 5 or 10. It really depends on how much time I got in the day, how many clips I get that I feel that are top 5 worthy. But I think we did a good job today, man. Very nice clips. Thank you guys so much again for watching. Don't forget to slap that like button. I'll see you guys back here next week. I'm out. Peace.